Stop turning pages. If you're a worship leader and you use Ableton Live on stage and use Music Stand by Planning Center for charts, there's no reason for you to have to reach over and swipe your chart. Hey, this is Will Doggett. Today I want to show you how to use Ableton Live to control Music Stand from Planning Center. It's super easy to do, and I'm going to show you a couple ways to make that happen. So let's get started. Now to start with, let's talk about how to connect to the iPad. Again, I'm going to show you a more advanced way in just a second that gives you a lot more stability, but let's just talk about the fastest, easiest way to try this out. So I'm going to use what's called RTP MIDI to create a network MIDI session between my Mac and my iPad. Now, I've created a couple different videos showing you how to do this a few different ways, and I linked to those below, but I'm going to show you how to do this really quickly. So I'm going to go into Audio MIDI Setup. I want to double click on network. First thing I should mention is I have both of these connected to the same Wi-Fi network. So as soon as I go into MIDI network setup here, and I have my session enabled, I've got a name in the Bonjour section here. It's enabled. Who may connect to me is set to anyone. And you see in the directory, as soon as I connect, you see Will's iPad show up. So I'm going to click on my iPad and hit connect. Now over in the participants section, you see my iPad show up in that list. Now what that means is my computer is now connected via Wi-Fi to my iPad, so I can send MIDI between Ableton Live and my iPad. Super straightforward and easy to do. So I'm gonna close Audio MIDI setup. I'm gonna go into Ableton. And what I need to do is tell Ableton, hey, route your MIDI out of Ableton into network session. So I'm gonna do Command Comma, which takes me into my preferences. I'm gonna go to Link MIDI, and I'm dealing with the output here. So I'm gonna scroll down to output until I see network session one. I'm going to go ahead and enable track. Now what that means is I can send MIDI out of my tracks down network session one to the iPad, and that's what we want. Now in order to make this easy, I've already created and I have a set of cues particularly for Music Stand. If you want to get these cues, you can head to studiostage.com/musicstand to get these completely free. So these cues are already assigned to functions in Planning Center. Now if you download the cues file, you're going to have to assign these to Music Stand the first time. So let me show you how to do that. I'm going to get out of my chart. I'm going to go back and I'm going to go over here to settings, and I want to scroll down to where I see MIDI input. Now you see four options here: next page, previous page, toggle metronome, and toggle audio player. Let's talk about how to assign these clips to those functions. And again, you can see on my iPad, I've already done that. So what I'm going to do is go up to this clip. Okay, next page, I've got my note, I've got it loaded, I'm ready to go. So what I want to do is go down to MIDI 2 here, and you can see it's set to route to network session 1, which means everything from this track is going to go to network MIDI into the iPad. So I'm going to select next page, so that's highlighted, it's expecting and looking for MIDI note, and I'm just going to click next page and then hit spacebar. And what that's going to do is it's going to find the MIDI note I sent, which is MIDI note 0. And you see this going up, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for the next one, I would hit previous page, and I'd hit that note and then press spacebar, and you'll see it assigns one. Go through and do this one time and then you're good to go. And we've got our cues file, so we're good to make this happen. So now what I'm gonna do is go back into my plan here, and I'm gonna open my chart. And let me show you how you can use these cues to program exactly when your pages will turn. So I'm gonna open a new Ableton Live session, and I'm just gonna lay these out against Live's timeline. I'm gonna open the browser over here to the left, and I'm gonna pull from my cues file to lay them into my session. Now, to learn how to add files to Live's browser, check out the video I linked below on understanding Live's browser. So what I'm gonna do is expand my Live set here, and then my track, and I'm just gonna load in the next page cue. Now, the one thing I don't like about this is you don't get absolute command. So I can't say go to song one, song two, song three using MIDI, but I can do next page and previous page. So I'm really only gonna just use the next page command to make this happen. So I would just lay these out, and whenever I need to change pages in my song, I would make sure I drop that cue in. So I'm gonna delete this audio file up here. And with just a couple cues laid into my set, I'm gonna go to the MIDI 2 section. And I'm going to make sure this is routed to network session one. So now I'm going to go ahead and press play. And let's take a look at Ableton. And as soon as we see this cue hit, we're going to see Music Stand switch to the next page. Okay, so there we go. Now we're going to see our next cue hit here again in a second. And after that hits, we're gonna see it change to the next page. So again, the great thing about this is what you wanna do is go through your individual songs, pull up your chart on Music Stand and try to figure out exactly where those cues should be placed. So again, this is a fantastic way to control Music Stand. But the one thing I don't like about this, as simple as this is, it doesn't require any extra gear, any extra pieces of gear to make it happen, is it's over wireless, so it's not incredibly stable. It's gonna work perfect until it doesn't work at all. So what I like doing is doing this hardwired, and the way I'm doing this is using a Play Audio 12 and a MIDI 4 Plus from iConnectivity. Now, both of these interfaces are connected using a Ethernet cable, and I've created an RTP network session between them. To learn how to do that, check out the previous video where I talk about creating an RTP MIDI session directly between devices. Now, the thing I want to point out about this is, yes, right now they're sitting 2 feet away from each other, but this Ethernet cable could be as long as you want it to be. It could also go over a switch so that you could have your Play Audio 12 on stage with Ableton Live and have your MIDI 4 Plus in a booth and have the iPad attached to it. But the way I like to think about this is I would have an iPad for every position where I need it to be there, and then a MIDI 4 Plus with it, so that one, it's wired, and that it's just an Ethernet cable from my Play Audio 12 into that box. So again, I could have three MIDI 4 Pluses all connected, and the way they're connected to the iPad is through iConnectivity special cable. So I've got the USB side of this plugged into input one on the MIDI 4 Plus, and then my Lightning connector plugged into the iPad. And again, the thing I love about this is the fact that this powers my device and it's a hardwire connection, and it's super, super simple to make happen. So now in Ableton, I'm gonna change my routing from network session to Play Audio 12. And what's happening is I'm gonna send my MIDI out of the Play Audio 12. It's gonna go through Ethernet into my MIDI 4 Plus, which is then connected to my iPad, which again is charging it and gives it a hardwire connection. All right, so with my Play Audio 12 connected, and again, to walk through our signal path, Play Audio 12 is connected to Ableton Live. We've got our Ethernet cable going into our MIDI 4 Plus, which could be wherever we want to on stage. And then we're connected from our MIDI 4 Plus into the iPad. So now I'm gonna press play, just jump a little before my cue. And as soon as my cue hits, you see it changes the page. Again, wired connection. And then it hits again and it's gonna change the page again. So this is my preferred way to do this because it gives me MIDI redundancy. This computer goes down, I can have it on my other computer. And it gives me a wired connection to my iPad and my iPad stays charged. So if you wanna learn more about using Ableton Live to control an iPad, to control a lighting console, maybe to control ProPresenter, then head to fromstudiostage.com/control. You'll see all the courses I've put together that talk about controlling any type of device you can think of and give you the foundational, fundamental knowledge that you need to know to make that happen. So we'd love to see you there. Again, fromstudiostage.com/control. Thanks so much for watching this tutorial. We'll see you next week. Bye.